Have you ever wondered how solar panels are made? These remarkable inventions harness the power of the sun and convert it into usable energy. They are a key player in the realm of renewable energy and are becoming increasingly vital in our quest for a sustainable future. At the heart of every solar panel lie photovoltaic or PV cells. These are the basic building blocks of any solar panel. Much like a bustling city, a solar panel is made up of several of these PV cells, all working together in harmony. These cells are the power stations of the solar world, capturing sunlight and converting it into electricity. But how exactly are these PV cells made, and how do they come together to form a solar panel? The process is both fascinating and complex. So if you're ready to embark on this enlightening journey, let's delve into the fascinating process of creating these power-generating marvels. Take a closer look and you'll discover that PV cells are the basic building blocks of any solar panel. Photovoltaic or PV cells are essentially tiny factories creating electricity from sunlight. These cells are typically made up of sandwiched layers of silicon combined with another element, often boron, gallium, or phosphorus. But why these elements, you may ask? Well, each brings a unique characteristic to the table, enhancing the functionality of the PV cell. To create a PV cell, we need two different types of silicon layers. The first is P-type silicon, which is silicon combined with either boron or gallium. This layer carries a positive charge. The second layer is N-type silicon, made by combining silicon with phosphorus. This layer carries a negative charge. When these two oppositely charged silicon layers are sandwiched together, an electric field is created. This field is crucial in the process of producing electricity. It's like setting up a one-way street for the electrons to travel, making sure they move in the right direction. Now let's delve a little deeper. The P-type silicon layer with its positive charge is ready and willing to accept electrons. On the other side, the N-type silicon layer with its negative charge is teeming with extra electrons. When sunlight hits these layers, it excites the electrons, causing them to jump from the N layer to the P layer. This movement of electrons is what we call electricity, but of course, we need a way to harness this electricity. That's where the electric wire comes in. By connecting these two layers with a wire, we allow the electricity to flow in an orderly manner, ready to be used. As you can see, the creation of a PV cell is a fascinating process involving a delicate balance of elements and charges. It's a testament to the power of science and innovation, transforming the simple sunlight into usable energy. Now that we've covered the basics of PV cells, let's explore how they come together to form solar panels. Did you know there are different types of PV cells? Indeed, the two most common types are monocrystalline and polycrystalline PV cells. These terms might sound complex, but they essentially refer to the structure of the silicon used. In a monocrystalline PV cell, the silicon originates from a single, continuous silicon block. This block is sliced into wafer-thin pieces or solid silicon slabs. The result is an incredibly efficient PV cell, thanks to the purity and uniformity of the silicon structure. On the other hand, polycrystalline PV cells are created from several silicon pieces melted together. This fusion process gives them their distinctive mosaic-like bluish hue. However, it also means they're slightly less efficient than their monocrystalline counterparts due to the diverse and irregular silicon structure. But don't let this deter you. Despite the efficiency difference, both types are excellent choices for solar energy and are widely used in the industry. With our PV cells ready, it's time to build the actual solar panel. Crafting a solar panel involves a meticulous process. It's essentially a symphony of elements, each playing its part to create a harmonious whole. Our first step is arranging the photovoltaic or PV cells. These cells, the heart of our solar panel, are arranged in a precise pattern, then carefully soldered together. This creates a pathway for electricity to flow freely from every corner of the panel, through the connecting wires, and onto the larger electrical system. The next layer is the backsheet, a guardian shield for our solar panel. Crafted from durable plastic or metal, it's installed on the bottom of the panel. Its role? To protect the delicate PV cells throughout the panel's life, defending them from weather, wear, and any other potential harm. Then we add a thin sheet of glass on top. This isn't just any glass though. Solar panel glass often features an anti-reflective coating, a clever little trick that helps increase light absorption and boosts the performance of our solar cells. Now we're ready to place these layers within a metal frame, the skeletal structure that will connect to mounting clamps on the roof. Finally, we introduce the junction box. Think of it as the gatekeeper of the solar panel, ensuring a one-way flow of electricity from the panel to the inverter. It's a vital component to prevent electricity from flowing back into the panel when it's not producing electricity, such as during the night or on dark and cloudy days. So, after arranging and soldering the PV cells, installing a backsheet and glass top, placing everything in a metal frame, and installing a junction box, we have our completed solar panel. It's a marvel of engineering, each component working in harmony to harness the power of the sun. Our solar panel is now complete, but how does it work? Well, that's a story for another scene. For now, let's take a moment to appreciate the intricate process that goes into crafting these remarkable devices, harnessing sunlight to power our world. Understanding how solar panels work is as intriguing as their construction. Imagine a sunny day. Sunlight strikes the surface of a photovoltaic cell, sparking the electrons in the negatively charged N-type layer. This stimulation prompts these electrons to break free, embarking on a journey into the electric field created by the meeting of N-type and P-type layers. Guided by metal contacts, these liberated electrons exit the solar panel, heading straight for the power inverter. Here, they truly shine. The power inverter, like a skilled translator, converts the raw direct current, or DC, into alternating current, or AC. This conversion morphs the sun's energy into a form that our homes and power grids can readily use. If the solar energy produced exceeds your home's needs, these surplus electrons simply pass through your net meter and venture out to the electrical grid, ready to power someone else's day. So there you have it, the journey of a solar panel from its humble beginnings as silicon and other elements to its ultimate purpose of harnessing the sun's energy to power our world.